going on, beautiful people? Welcome back to Funnelheads, and today we're going to be talking about the important topic of Carnival Cruise Line bubble tours. This is one of those things that a lot of people don't really understand what they're getting themselves into as far as cruising with an unvaccinated guest. And this hopefully will help you with that. So before we get into it, if you're new to the channel or returning, you haven't subscribed yet, please consider doing so, becoming part of that Funnelhead family. We'd love to have you. Also, commenting and liking on the video is truly appreciated and does help the channel grow. So thank you so much for taking a moment to do that. But let's get right into it. So what is a Carnival Cruise Lines bubble tour? Well, this is a tour that is dedicated to groups of people that are unvaccinated. So for example, my family, me and my wife are fully vaccinated. However, my four-year-old son is not, of course, he's not of age to do so. So we only were allowed to get off of the ship if we were doing a Carnival Cruise Line shore excursion that was labeled as a bubble tour. And you can find out which shore excursions are bubble tours because it will say in the description. Now the little bit of an issue with these are, when we cruise specifically, it took almost up until the cruise to get our son's vaccine exemption letter approved. It was about 7 or 8 days before we sailed. Now, hopefully Carnival will do a little bit better at getting these exemption letters approved earlier, because the issue that we had was we couldn't book any shore excursions, or we didn't want to book any shore excursions until we found out that he was approved. Because, of course, if he wasn't approved, then, you know, we didn't want to waste the money. Of course, you know, they would have refunded it eventually, but we didn't want to spend money and then wait to get it back, you know, eventually. You know how the cruise refunds have been taking a little while, so we didn't want to go through that process. So but unfortunately, by not booking it, a lot of them sold out right away. So which was fine, of course. We knew what we were getting ourselves into. We read all the emails, we read the contract, we knew that we can only get off the ship if we were in one of those bubble tour excursions. Now, there is an exception to this rule, and that is if you are traveling to Half Moon Cay or Princess Cay, you can get off the ship if you're unvaccinated at this point. And that is because Carnival Cruise Lines, of course, owns those islands. So on our vacation, on our cruise, we did a back-to-back, and we got off at Half Moon Cay, which was absolutely amazing. And then on the following week, we were able to get off in Curacao because we were able to book a bubble tour. A bubble tour that originally was actually sold out, but I guess a family or whoever canceled, and we were able to rebook it at the kind of the day before, maybe two days before. But long story short is, if you are traveling with anybody that is unvaccinated, whether it's kids, you know, medical reasons, religious reasons, whatever it is, and you have an approved exemption letter, just know that you are not allowed to get off the ship unless you're on a bubble tour. So I would recommend either booking the bubble tour ahead of time so that way they're not sold out, or just expect to not get off the ship unless you're going to Half Moon Cay or Princess Cay. And on the ship, we realized that there were a lot of families, especially with kids, that did not understand that, or maybe didn't read that, or whatever the case was, because there was more times than not that, you know, families with kids came up to us and asked us if we knew about it. And we did. But I just don't know if they really knew what they were getting themselves into. So I just wanted to make a video to kind of clear that up, what to expect. Again, we expected to pretty much not get off the ship the entire 14 days. We were completely fine with that. I do hope that Carnival, like I said, can go through the approved exemption list a little bit faster. I would love to see like 2 to 3 weeks before the cruise, because, you know, you're preparing flights, hotels, transportation to and from the port, And then the shore excursions, and then everything else that, you know, you want to do, whether it's, you know, the Cheers package, spa, you know, reservations, all that good stuff. So I would love to see Carnival. I know, obviously, they just got back into this. It's only going to get better. Again, just go into your cruise thinking worst case scenario, and you will be pleasantly surprised. We were absolutely fine. We loved every second of the cruise, and that was just because we have, you know, a positive, upbeat mindset on situations. We were just happy to be on a cruise ship after a year and a half, over a year and a half of not sailing. So we were absolutely fine just being on the ship, relaxing, spending time with our little one. And that's what you got to do. So please ask any questions that you might, you know, if you need any more information, if I can explain it a little bit better, you know, let me know in the comment section below. Hopefully I'll see you right back here in the next video or on a cruise ship one day. Catch you later.